Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I'm gonna start off with concealer, doing a nice plum burgundy makeup tutorial. So start off with the Maybelline Master Conceal Concealer in the color medium, deep, I think. And I'm gonna put out all of my lid, and then I'm gonna set it with the Sacha buttercup powder. Just so that the eyeshadow wouldn't crease and it will blend easily. Now going into the Juvias Place Palette, Masquerade Palette, and I'm using the first color Burkina. I'm going to crease with the Morphe brush. I don't remember the name of it offhand. I'll try to put it in the description box. I'm just going to blend that in my crease, more on the outside to the top, towards my brow bone, and then a little bit in the inside when I have less product on the brush. So that's going to be doing that now. So yeah. This is my second video, and actually going pretty good, so. Yeah, and I'm trying this voice, but tell me if the voice was something good or not. Anyways, I'm going into the color Cairo, I think, in the same palette, on top of the excess, because it does have some loose glitter in it. But once you tap off the excess, the glitter just falls off enough for the center matte eyeshadow. So I'm doing that, and then I blended it a little bit lower, but it almost essentially in the same spot as the first color in my crease. I blend it out. Sorry, my face looking so sad. I don't know why, I was just concentrating. Now I'm going into the color Zulu, I think, and I'm putting that a little bit lower, and I'm just packing it on first and then blending it out a little bit lower than the crease, just to get some definition on my eyes. So yeah. Now we're going into the color Zulu. I think I just said that. I will say it down below in the description box. I can't remember, and I can't really see too good. I don't have the palette in front of me, but just blending the eye, my crease as well, a little bit lower, blending up. Just like it's in definition, just packing on, building up color. So everything will blend seamlessly in the end. Now going into the color Zobo, which is like a dark purple, kind of plummy, and I'm gonna pack that all over the lid, and that is dry, but I'm not wetting my brush anything, no concealer at the bottom, just dry, and that palette, the color so pigmented, that palette real good. If you're planning to like buy anything from Juvia's Place, I recommend that palette, the only palette I have from them, but the palette real good. So I want to try more things on them, but just that palette, it real good. So now let's blend out the edges with the same brush. I use that brush for that whole look, except for the packing on part. That brush real good. I got it from a Morphe Media subscription box with Life Glam. So I just blend out the edges, making sure everything looks seamless and, you know, snatched. And then I'm taking a clean brush. This is a Luxie Taper Blending Brush, 229 brush. And I blend out all the edges, making sure everything is seamless. And, yeah, so it's making everything good. Blend all the inside, the outside, everything. Now I'm taking an eyeliner brush, also for Morphe. I will link it down below. And I'm squeezing it with some wipes to make sure all the hairs stick in one place in a thin line. And I'm taking some gel liner I buy from Ambrosia in Tongue in Trinidad. It was $80 and it's not really my favorite. That's what I had. I was desperate to find an eyeliner, and that's all I could find. So, but I don't recommend it. But it worked for what it's worth. Actually, no, not even for what it's worth, because it was $80 and it's expensive. But that is life. I had to work with it for now until I buy a new eyeliner. So I just remind, I tried to do it on camera. I kind of get it, but I still end up going off camera doing the other side because it will take way too long. And my first video is already 26 minutes. I want to make this one a little bit shorter. So yeah, I just do my eyeliner. And I should skip forward to the other one in a little while. Yes! We have eyeliner looking slick and cook out a bitch. Anyways, I'm using the LA Girl primer. It's a pore filling primer. I just put it in my pores, rub on the teeth. I put some on my forehead, but mostly focusing it on my pores. And then now using the LA Girl Pro Concealer in the color orange, is a color corrector. And I'm using it on my dark smile lines because it's sad. Yeah.
What is it?
Nothing.
It's not my
mm-hmm. I have no choice. Mommy says she don't want my home alone because I'll be inviting friends and all kind of thing. Did you not say that? Yes, apparently.
I don't
try anywhere for you. I'm talking about living. Mommy, when did you ever see me drink alcohol? You just try to give me alcohol and I don't even take it. You'll be crazy. Yeah, that was so awkward. I just wanted to leave it in because I find it was funny. But yeah. Back to the smile line. So I don't know, just so be like we move and everything, but I don't know if that have anything to do with it. But I just get these two dark smile lines on my well, they act like Max. I'm a smile as I don't know where it come from. But if you have any tips or any fading cream, please let me know. I would really appreciate that. So this blend is with a brush. And yes, I put on foundation and I get in my eyebrow. Story of my life. I'm an epic feel and I'm a klutz. By using the Jordana foundation, complete coverage foundation and concealer in the color Golden Toffee, I think 11, and the L'Oreal Pro Matte, infallible Pro Matte in the color, I can't remember. I'll link it down below. And let's blend out with that Morphe brush. It's in color matte line. I'll link it down below as well. And my same rose water that I showed in my last video in the Sasha can. It's not really Sasha fix it spray. It's really rose water mixed with diluted with water. And it's work like the Amarillo Pedasco facial spray. And it's bomb. If you don't know what video I'm talking about, I will link it down below as well. That was my first ever video, so I would like you to watch it and leave a comment and, you know, everything like that. So let's blend out the foundation. The Jordana one is more dewy and obviously the L'Oreal one more matte. So it does make a real combination. And plus the L'Oreal one more real orange and the Jordana one more my skin tone. Now, I told you I don't use concealer in my last video, which I don't typically use it, but I find for this like glam look, it needed something. My face is looking too like the same color, so I just put a little bit of concealer under my eyes. And that's when you put that paper because I really find concealer just make me like get flashback and it's get creepy and dry in the day and I don't really like that look. So but for this look, how the look is a kind of glam look, I'll just put a bit of concealer just to, you know, make my face like make my under look more pushed out and, you know, like that. I blend out with another Morphe brush. I get all my brushes from the Life Glam subscription box with Morphe Me. It's a real good deal. So I think it's like $20 and again 5 or 6 brushes. Now using the Sacha Buttercup again with an angle brush on Caroline Pennywise, I get it for real affordable. And I just set it under my eyes because I don't bake anymore because of the fact that the Sacha Buttercup powder is a good bit lighter than my skin tone. I realize when I pack on too much and bake, when I take a picture, I'll be looking crazy. I'll be looking like, so, to, you know, get away from that, I just don't really pack it on this one a little bit. And I'll take my black opal deluxe finishing powder in the color 05 deep. With the Morphe brush, I used to blend out my foundation and I set on my face. I mix a little bit of the Sacha Buttercup powder actually with it because the black opal by itself is a little bit orange. And I poke myself in the eye again. So now I contour in with the LA Girl Pro Face Powder in the color Cocoa. I contour in. First, I was using this angle brush again, but after I realized that I didn't really use that brush, I like to use a different brush you can see just now. Yeah, wrong brush. I like to use this Morphe brush here that's coming up. I'll link that down below as well. I'll link everything down below. I keep saying that. I'll link everything down below. So yeah, I just use that brush to contour my face. I don't really like a strong contour, but I like a little definition because my face will be looking too flat. Just contour my cheekbones and I have a humongous forehead, so you know, I gotta make that look a little bit smaller. Pouring too much there. But whenever you like pouring too much powder, let's keep blending stuff, everything, and then take back your powder brush and go over it as you still do just now. And go over it and it will clear up real easy. So yeah, now we're gonna spray my face and I'm gonna do highlighter. This is the Ofra Beverly Hills highlighter. It's so bomb. I got it from a Boxy Jam. I didn't pay for it. I get it from a Boxy Jam and it's so good. All I use is the gold color because the rest don't really work for me, but it's so good. And I just use my Real Techniques satin brush. First I spray my face and then after I put it on and look at it. Look at it, oh my gosh, oh my god, it's so pretty. So yeah, just putting on the highlight, you know, we gotta glow to the gods, we gotta slay, honey. So yeah, just paint on that, highlight, put it on my nose. Yes. And all of you who do like plenty nose highlight, who care though? Oh my god, be so extra in this voiceover. I have so much fun doing this madness. Okay, anyways. So now using some Milani blush and rose vino, I think. And I put in also angle brush also from Carly Cabada and Pennywise. Sorry if I'm talking too fast, you guys. You will let me know in the comments. Yeah, singing You the Baddest from Future, Nicki Minaj. That song is, I had that song on replay. Anyways, yeah, so I use any Big Shot mascara. I don't even know why I just not sure. Like, oh my god, I was talking way too damn much. Anyways, I use the hack I used from the hack I showed from last time, the clear brow gel as the clear mascara as brow gel. So I use it on my eyebrows, and after I remember now I use the eyelashes, Ruby Kisses eyelashes in Demi Wisp, and then the Big Shot mascara from Maybelline to blend my eyelashes and false eyelashes. And then I use all the colors I use on my top lid under my eyes, blend it out, and then now I'm taking this Jordana lip pencil. It's really a lip pencil in cherry wood. But it's real creamy, and I don't use them on lips because I really like the color on my lip personally. So I use it as eyeliner, and it looks so good with that look. It's like a cherry wood color, like a cherry color. Now I'm using the ColourPop Ultra Satin Lip in the color Two Lips, and I feel like it went so good with this look. So yeah. I just put it on right now. I shouldn't know how I put it on. I don't know why I put it in this motion. I could have put it faster than this, but I'll leave it like that for it to see what I put it on and everything like that. After this, after putting the lipstick, the look basically finished. You just want to set the face one more time. Watch me checking out if the lipstick looking good or not. Fine. So just spraying the face one more time to make sure everything's sinking, and that's basically it. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please subscribe for more videos, and I love you. Bye.